Hello there, guys. Coaster Charles here, Doncaster born, but built for theme parks, and welcome to a Theme Park Newsroom update from Knott's Berry Farm. Now, the reason why I wanted to record this video tonight is because I got a comment from someone asking me to look at this, and I sort of looked into this and thought, hang on a minute, this could be interesting. So basically what's happened is, there's a permit's been filed for a Bolliger and Mabillard installation from Knott's Berry Farm. So we're going to talk about the potentialities of what this could be, and also share my thoughts on it and why I think it or think not to be a new coaster. So before we get started, guys, please like the video if you loved it. Comment down below your thoughts and opinions on this. Subscribe to the channel if you're new around here. Click the notification bell so you never miss YouTube video. Also, guys, check the description down below for social media links and also the Google Forms link where you can submit your own ideas for the channel. Got Alton Towers tribute preview coming Sunday, review coming Tuesday, the trips on the Monday. So if you do see me at the park, don't be afraid to say hi. And for now, guys, let's have a look exactly what's going on with Knott's Berry Farm, and is there a potential coaster for 2022 in the works? So the main source of evidence behind this potential thing is this. Now, you can see there the date. You can see Bolliger and Mabillard, Knott's Berry Farm is the customer to the supplier of B&M, and the details says material for installation of amusement park NRHS code 950890. So it's a very interesting thing there. Now, I know one thing that it could be, and this is the thing I was thinking about when I sort of got told about this news and heard about this news and saw this for myself. Is it installing brand new parts for their B&M Invert Silver Bullet? Now, for those of you who don't know what Silver Bullet is, it's a Bolliger and Mabillard inverted roller coaster located at the park. For those of you who need a little reminder as to what the coaster sort of entails in its twisted layout, it has a length of 3,125 feet, a height of 146 feet, a drop of 109 feet, a speed of 55 miles per hour. It's 2.5 minutes long with 6 inversions. And while the Silver Bullet is technically has 3 trains, only 2 can be used simultaneously. The third exists, so they may operate at full capacity while a train is being serviced. It costs $60 million and has a capacity of 1,300 riders per hour. Now, my first thought was parts for Silver Bullet, maintenance for Silver Bullet, extra supplies of track for Silver Bullet, you know, for a whole track modification and maintenance. Now, I think if it said that, I think it would have said parts. Now, of course, it says material for installation. So I think that could lead to parts for Silver Bullet. However, material for installation could also mean just brand new track entirely. Because, of course, if it was installation, it'd be a new thing. If it was material for maintenance or material for refurbishment, then it would be for Silver Bullet. But because it's material for installation, it gives me less and less, well, more and more doubt and less truth to Silver Bullet getting maintenance work. So this sort of scoots towards a brand new coaster. Now, I'm going to share with you on your screen now, the potential sites for what I think could be a potential site for a new coaster if they were going to do one. Now, obviously, you can see the rapids that's sort of in the mix there. You see the rapid site in there. And you see a bit of stretched land. Now, that was where some people have predicted a brand new coaster before, like a hyper coaster or something like that. But it's sort of more towards the side, like the sort of opposite angle. They could sort of go with that, but I wanted to include the rapids in if there was a ride to be removed. But I think if it was going to be, you know, a potential site, I mean, you can see it on your screen right now. I mean, the site in yellow is what I think could be the site if you were to include a new ride. The thing in blue is what I think could be the site anyway. And, you know, I think it's interesting. It's going to be interesting to see, you know, exactly what could happen here. I mean, I'm quite interested to see what could happen. Now, obviously, as you can see, the blue and yellow lines intertwine. That could indicate that both sides could be connected, and they could include the rapid site involved in the blue and yellow cross-referenced sites. Now, in terms of what B&M coaster I think would go on that site and why, well, I'm going to share that right now with you guys. So there we are, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages. That is speaking about what I think's going on here with Knott's Berry Farm and the permits for a B&M. Now, obviously, like I said, material for installation could mean installing brand new parts for the park's Silver Bullet roller coaster. However, I think it would have said material for refurbishment or maintenance, not for installation. So I think it sort of leads me towards a brand new coaster. Whether it's 2022 or not, I really don't know. It could be 2023 for all we know. But if they're going to go with a brand new Bolliger and Mabillard roller coaster from scratch, what could I think they'll go with? Well, they can't go with a dive coaster because they've got Hang Time, which has a beyond vertical drop. And also, don't forget, in California, they've got other parks with dive coasters. Obviously, it's Emperor at SeaWorld San Diego in California. So, you know, they don't want to go for something that's too near. And you don't want to go for something that's too cookie cutter, if you know what I mean, because don't forget you've got dive coasters in other Cedar Fair parks. Yukon Striker and Balraven are the two big ones in the Cedar Fair chain. So what else could they go for? Well, they did shelve the plans for a wing coaster at King's Dominion. Could they go now and take those shelved plans from King's Dominion and bring it to Knott's Berry Farm? It's a theory. It might be something to think about. I think that a wing coaster would be great for Knott's Berry Farm. I think, could you imagine having like a nice keystone, key gate signature element like Gatekeeper at Cedar Point? I think there'd be a really good opportunity to do that. Whether it's a launched wing coaster, they could do something very unique for that area and for that state of California. So I feel like there's a chance there with that. In terms of other coasters, there isn't really much other options apart from a Hyper slash Giga coaster. Now, that could be out of the price range, you never know, for Knott's Berry Farm's next big investment, but, you know, I think that it wouldn't be a bad shout. I mean, you look at Orion at King's Island, Leviathan at Canada's Wonderland, you know, Fury 325 at Carowinds, Hyper or Giga, I think it'd be a great investment for Knott's Berry Farm, and I think it'd be a wonderful investment for California as well. A modern Hyper coaster or a Giga coaster. It would be interesting to see if they did go with the Giga coaster or they just stick to the Hyper coaster. Me personally, I think they'll stick to the Hyper coaster because I think all us enthusiasts have an idea of how Cedar Fair treat their parks. It's pretty much Cedar Point, then a couple of parks just down below, and then the rest of them get barely anything. And we're talking the likes of Worlds of Fun, Valley Fair, Michigan's Adventure, that kind of thing. But they are going to spread their capex of investment across all the parks. They're going to try and get at least one new investment every year in anything, whether it's a ride or a show or an event or something like that, something major each and every year, I think, is the plan for Cedar Fair, for their long-term strategy plan. And I think that Knott's Berry Farm getting a brand new roller coaster either next year or the year after could be very interesting. Do I think it's 2022? No. I think with the first permits going in, and I don't think we've heard anything about site clearing just yet, unless I'm mistaken, I think we're looking here at a new for 2023 investment. I think Knott's Berry Farm will be the part to watch out for in 2023. I don't think it's 2022. Yes, we're, you know, towards the end of June now, but in my opinion, I think it's still, we're pretty much nearly at the end of June, you know, but I think it's still too late in my opinion. I mean, it might not be late, but we'll see what happens. But don't forget, King's Island started work on Orion very, very early, quite early on, in fact, especially since they had to sort of fill that plot of land where Firehawk was. So I think that if it was a wing coaster, then maybe we could still look at 2022. If it was something big like a Hyper or a Giga, I don't think we're looking at 2022 here. I think we're looking at the early part of 2023, if not summer 2023. If it is a brand new coaster, like I said, it could just be parts for Silver Bullet. But let me know what you think in the comments down below. What do you think about this? What are your thoughts? Do you like my theories? Do you not like my theories? If not, respectfully, tell me why in the comments down below. Put your own theories in there. I'd love to hear them. Reply to every single comment as I always do. You know I do. And for now, guys, that is it for this video. My name is Coaster Child. Keep living the coaster life. We've got videos packed to come out this weekend, including the trip preview for Alton Towers Resort on the Monday. That preview will be coming out on the Sunday. That'll be a full video. You know, it'll be way over the 10-minute mark. previewing all the attractions, previewing my potential highlights of the trip, and also have a look inside the sort of history behind the trip. You know, it's going to be my first theme park visit in, what, nearly 2 years, or around about 2 years now. The last time I visited Alton Towers was June 2019. That was the last visit I had to a theme park. Yes, I had visits to York Dungeon in February 2020 and Yorkshire Wildlife Park during the pandemic back in October 2020. But I didn't have, you know, an Alton Towers visit or a proper amusement park slash theme park visit since 2019. So it's my first pandemic visit to a theme park. So I really hope you are going to enjoy that preview on Sunday. We still got some videos to come out before then. We've got a video on Latin America's tallest observation wheel coming to Sao Paulo in Brazil. Hoping to release that tomorrow, fingers crossed, because that video has been sitting in my files for a good week or two now. The I'm a Celebrity Jungle Challenge attraction that's opening in Manchester this summer, that's going to be uploaded probably tomorrow as well, so stay tuned for that. And for now, guys, my name is Coast Shell. Keep living the coast life. Please, let's get to 3,000 subscribers. Better than that, let's try and get to 4K, because I might, you never know, I might make some little merchandise if we get to 4K. So if you want me to get to 4,000 subscribers and release some stuff, then please just hit the subscribe button if you're new around here and you haven't subscribed already. And for now, guys, keep living the coast life, and I'll see you guys next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have a Knott-tastic day. What do you think? B&M or maintenance? Comment down below.